Glad to have you with us in the studio. I'm Reese Davis, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. In the SEC, there is one certainty. You never get a rest. You never get a chance to catch your breath. If you don't believe it, just try taking your C game or something to a place like Lexington or Nashville or Starkville. You know what'll happen? You'll walk out with a loss. You have to bring your best in every single game in the SEC. That's going to do it for us here on the pregame show. NCAA Football 14 action coming at you right now. Brett Nessler and Kirk Herbstreit.
Hedges that have encircled the field since the stadium's very first game against Yale back in 1929. And now it's time for the coin toss, and it's brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything. Has the ball set how he wants it, and we're just about ready to kick this game off, folks. He'll return it from the six. Brought down at the 48-yard line.
Hey, that's a pretty good return there to open this game up.
The quarterback leads the team out on the field for the first drive. The middle for a nice game. He makes it to the 45-yard line. To his tight end. He gets hit out of bounds at the 38.
Hey, it's a first down for this offense that keeps everybody enthusiastic. You can see the momentum that this offense is gaining. The coaches and the players on the sideline are fired up, and hey, it's a new set of downs.
He steps out at about the 37-yard line.
If you're the defense, who do you try to cover this guy with? He's too fast for most linebackers. He's too big for most corners. You have to rely on your safeties, who generally aren't very good in one-on-one coverage.
From the 16-yard line, first down. On the extra point. So that's a 7-play, 52-yard drive, and they come away with 7 points.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
Georgia is lining up to kick this one off. They'll bring him down at the 29. So let's see what the offense can do as they come out onto the field.
He's to the 40. Gets to around the 42. What a run.
Here they give it to the tailback and a little misdirection play. And you can see the athleticism and the ability to make guys miss. Nice play.
Looking for his man. Incomplete.
I mean, he has his wide receiver wide open. You spend all those hours during the week to be able to get prepped and ready to go. You got an open man like this, just step and deliver and make the throw.
He's scrambling. And they got it. It looks like the defensive end that got in there.
Yes, it was. He did a wonderful job of fighting off blocks to bring the quarterback down.
Third down, and they need to get it inside the 48. Got a man. Watch out here. They'll bring him down at the 44. Makes the catch, but just not enough for the first.
Yeah, they're going to come up a little bit short here. Nice job by the defense of preventing this completion from turning into a first down.
Pennington, back to return it. Made at the 28-yard line. They did a great job on their last drive, moving the ball down the field for a touchdown. Let's see if they can duplicate that on this drive.
As long as this quarterback has time to throw, then you can guarantee that he'll find the open man.
That makes it second and 10.
Georgia is up a score. And he's going to be sacked. So they set the safety on the blitz, and he'll get credit for the sack.
Nobody was left to pick him up. He disguised the blitz very well and really made a nice play on the quarterback.
Third and long now after the sack. Setting up blockers or running backs. Got it on the screen.
Call it a gain of 3 yards. That'll bring up fourth and 13.
Gray is back to receive. And he's tackled at the 48. Georgia's defense got the stop they wanted on that first drive. Now let's see if they can do it again.
And just listen to this crowd, Brad. I mean, you can practically feel the energy coming down from the crowd and how it's impacting these players.
You never like to have to play from behind, but a deficit this manageable shouldn't be in the front of their mind. They just need to go out there and play. Quick throw, incomplete. One of his receivers. So it's second and 10. Ball on their own 48. He's taken down at the 49-yard line. And they get the sack.
You can't take sacks like that as a quarterback. You just can't. If you can't find a receiver, get out of the pocket and throw the ball away.
And that'll be three and out. After the sack, it's now fourth and long. Medlock is the punter. He's taken down at the 33. Not much luck the last time this offense had the ball. Georgia up 7 points.
Mike,
finds his way to the 43-yard line. Moves up in the pocket and down he goes.
Loss of 7 yards on the play. That makes it third and seven.
From their own 36-yard line, third down. Both offenses trying to find their rhythm in that first quarter. Low scoring and close right now. Georgia in front, 7-0. And we're back for more action here in quarter number two. Five guys will be out in the pattern as they're in the shotgun. Zips it to the back. He's knocked out of bounds around the 47-yard line. Fires out to his receiver, and he is drilled at the 47. Again on third down. Georgia is up by a touchdown. Dumps it incomplete. Wanted the screen.
McQueen was the intended receiver on the play. Fourth down.
Cummings looking to get some distance on this one to give his team the field position advantage. So this one goes into the end zone, and that'll be a touchback. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Second down, 10 yards to go. Catches it and hit immediately for a loss. Fourth and long here after the sack. Everybody up close. It looks like they're coming after this kick. Bennington fields it at the 39. Tackle at the 31. With one quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these two squads. Might be neck and neck the whole way. Georgia is up 7. After a decent pickup. And he tackles him hard at the 17-yard line.
Mike.
corner.
The 10. And that sets them up with a first and goal. Touchdown, Bulldogs. So he punches it into the end zone for the second time today.
This young man is no stranger to the end zone. That's two rushing scores for him. And you have to love the way he's been running the ball all game.
He makes the PAT. Like they're ready for the kick. Fielded at the 4. He's taken down at the 34-yard line. So now both teams come trotting back out onto the field. Quickly to the back, but he can't haul it in.
Perfect timing to jar the ball loose and not pick up the penalty. That was a solid play.
It's second and 10. Ball on the 34-yard line. Harris on the inside handoff. Nice gain as he works to the right side. Conversion there.
This offense has a tendency to run the football in this situation, as you can see, with good reason.
Throws complete. He's got room to work, and he hits him hard at the 38-yard line.
That'll make it second and 4.
Makes it out to about the 30.
That's good for a gain of 8 yards. That makes it first and 10.
Got hit and still completed it. Brought down around the 19-yard line.
Getting him the ball in the passing game creates real havoc for the defense. There aren't many linebackers who can stay with him in coverage, that's for sure.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 19-yard line. And he's tackled right around the 10-yard line.
The quarterback and his receiver make a great play here and convert on an early down.
And this play is number 8 on the drive.
The Rebels saw one of their key guys go down earlier, but it looks like he might be able to get back in the action.
He fights forward to about the 7. Now he tries to buy some time. And down he goes at the 7. Touchdown, Rebels. The PAT.
A nice 10 play, 67-yard drive, and they get it in for 7.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass. Just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
He makes it out to maybe the 30-yard line. Moment momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Georgia is up a score. Now he's scrambling. And they make the stop at the 37.
They got a few yards there, but they need to be thinking bigger right now.
Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. They'll spread the field here. Let's see what the defense does with a five wide outlook. Fires out to his wide out. Tackle made at the 45-yard line. And they're going to put six DBs on the field to counter that five receiver look. He goes out of bounds at the 49.
That makes it 76.
Their own 49-yard line. Second down. And it's caught, and he's brought down quickly. Georgia's going to have to use their second time out of the half. Miner picks up around 5 yards with that catch. Tackle at about the 37-yard line. Downtown. Rose, complete touchdown. And he adds the extra point. A six play, 70-yard drive, and they put up 7 points. Williams has his kick team lined up, and he is set to kick this one off. Sends it sailing downfield, and it sails out of the end zone for a touchback.
Well, this is turning into a shootout here. Now, remember, the last time we saw this offense out in the field, they answered the bell and scored a touchdown. Can they do that now a second time?
So it's time to see this offense go to work again.
This defense couldn't stop them from moving the ball and inevitably finding the end zone.
It out left to the running back, and he shoved out of bounds the 37-yard line.
That's a gain of 12 on the play. First down.
From their own 37-yard line, it's first down. Quick throw. Inbounds to make a nice catch.
Gain of 19 yards. That makes it first and 10.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 44.
Hey, watch the screen. Watch the screen. Watch the screen.
Let's go. Red.
Stays in bounds and made a nice catch.
First down.
To his tight end, but it's knocked loose.
The pass was right on target, so that took a perfectly timed hard hit to knock it free. Strong defense to deny the completion.
Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 26-yard line. He's going to try and scramble. Now he's going to run and watch out. They'll bring him down right around the 14-yard line. Quickly to the tight end. He's got it. Touchdown. And and he tacks on the extra point.
A nice six-play, 76-yard drive, and a touchdown's a result.
Brad, I love these kind of drives. They're old school, grind it out and earn the yards and just rip the heart right out of that defense.
Ole Miss is ready to kick it away. He'll return it from the 4-yard line. He makes it out to maybe the 23-yard line.
Quarterback is on his way back onto the field, and he led a great drive last time out.
Georgia up 7 points. He's to the 40. He's taken down at the 45. He chucks it downfield. Drops it. From their own 45-yard line, it's second down. And we'll probably see how far he can throw it, as it should be the last play before the half. He airs it out. Huge gain, and that sets him up nicely with a first and goal. Well, we've got a barn burner here, and at the end of the first half, our score, Georgia in front, 21-14.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show, presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollack here, completely locked in on that first half. Both of these defenses are opportunistic and very good at forcing turnovers. But both quarterbacks, David, have done a very good job on trying to maintain an aggressive mindset. They haven't forced the ball. The runners have done a good job keeping it put away.
Yeah, and as much as you preach that all throughout the week, it's still hard to do. It's hard to do. And being able to see what you see on the defensive side of the football and adjust to it offensively. How about protecting the quarterback so he's not getting hit from the blind side, fumbling the football, ball carriers running with the football, keeping their body, not giving it away. So, you know, between running backs, receivers, and quarterbacks, offensive linemen blocking, did a great job executing on the offensive side of the football, not to give away any turnovers.
That's going to do it at halftime. Just about ready to start the second half.
All right, you finish it up, bud. I'm going to get something in the cafeteria. I'm hungry.
Wait, don't leave until you get my order. Brad Kirk, take the second half.
All right, Reese and David, thanks, guys. Second action, just about ready to start here. He's to the 20. Tackled at the 20-yard line. This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking, if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. Throws incomplete, intended for his wideouts. Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 20-yard line. Is out to the tailback on the screen, and he's level at the 21. Pass incomplete, trying to get it to his receiver. Is the punter. To about the 37-yard line. They'll take over here, ready to start a new series. Is up by a touchdown. Gets the ball here and brought down in the backfield.
No gain on the play. That makes it second and 10.
Check 59. Mike is 59.
Quick out to his receiver. He's tackled at the 32.
That'll bring up 36.
incomplete.
The ball just sailed on him, and he knows it. He'll get it next time.
So the kicker comes out. He'll try to put 3 points on the board. George is hoping to make this a two-score game. It's up. Looks long enough. And it's off the upright. No good. There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. They'll bring him down for a loss on the play. Just nowhere for the ball carrier to go as the linebacker met him in the backfield.
Boy, what great play recognition by this linebacker. He saw the run was coming, and he just shot through the gap and made a great tackle.
Second down, about 12 yards to go. Ball on their own 31. Throws, and that one's going to hit the ground, incomplete. He wants it all. Oh, he had a shot at the...
You like a team that's ready to defend the pass. It takes some preparation to get in the way of a pass like that.
Pennington is back deep to return. He makes it to the 45-yard line. The Rebels have really surprised everybody in this football game.
They have not been intimidated at all, which is great to see. The attitude and effort of this team's put them in a position where they got a shot to win this game here in the second half.
So you wonder what kind of excitement we'll see this time around. Georgia is up 7. Gets to about the 47-yard line.
Gain of 2 yards. That makes it second and 8.
Three down. Check number 9. Check 26.
And he makes it out to about the 47-yard line.
No gain. That'll bring up 3rd and 8.
Three down. Check 59. Mike is 59. Mike is 59.
Fires quick out to the receiver, and he can't make the grab.
Roll the intended receiver on the play. That makes it 4th and 8.
Gray is the deep man awaiting the return. Tackle at the 24. So he managed to get a few yards on the run back.
Yeah, but I'll tell you, Brad, with so much traffic in the middle there, it really makes it tough to break free.
This deficit can be easily overcome. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. Runs left and can't get back to the line of scrimmage. Away here on 3rd down. They'll drop him for a loss.
That might have actually been a situation where he should have kept it. The back didn't have any room to run.
Medlock to punt. Hit out of bounds around the 43-yard line. Not a bad return. Both squads are digging in now. Let's see what happens on this next drive. Georgia is up a score. Brought down right around the 32-yard line.
That's a nice job by the quarterback to pitch the ball, and it got him a first down.
makes the catch, and he's got nowhere to go. The carry.
This is a good call by the defensive coordinator. He guessed run, and when the offense came with it, his guys were in position to make the stop.
So it's fourth down. They'll call on the field goal unit here for this long field goal attempt. Georgia can make this a two-possession game with this field goal. It has the distance, and he nails the long field goal. He's got to be happy about that kick.
Oh, no question. This kid is just a solid kicker.
24-14, Georgia. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Their last drive ended in a punt, so this quarterback's going to be looking for something better on this drive.
If they're going to make a comeback in this game, it's going to have to start now. This offense has to get rolling.
And down he goes at the 36. Nice run there.
That'll make it second and four.
So with one quarter remaining, the Bulldogs lead 24-14. We're just about set to start action here again in the fourth quarter. Gets out to around the 48.
That makes it first and 10.
He's on the run. He's at the 40. And they make the stop at the 32-yard line. The quarterback in the gun. Empty backfield. Five wide receivers in the formation. Inside run, and he's hit hard.
That makes him second and 10.
Complete. He's got room. Knocked out of bounds at the 27-yard line. Five wide. Quick throw, and he's got the tight end again. That's a great tackle at the 22-yard line. Nice gain, but not enough for the first down.
Yeah, that's a nice play there. They did everything right except get enough yards for the first down.
And it's the offense that takes the field on fourth down. Keeps it on the ground, and they won't get the first down. Football will change hands as they fail to convert on fourth down.
Well, the offense looked like they wanted to bounce the ball to the outside. But this defense just has too much speed. They did a good job of shutting off the edge and preventing the ball carrier from getting down.
Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop. Fires it quickly. Second and 10. Ball on their own 27. Quickly to the tailback. Tackle made right around the 36-yard line. Tackle after a decent run up the gut. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 43-yard line. Tackle at about the 47-yard line. Less than 3 minutes in the game. He makes his way to about the 32. From the 32-yard line, it's first down. McQueen picks up about 4 yards on the play. The Rebels will use their first time out of the half. Heading for the corner. Inside the 10. And he will score. The extra point. A seven-play, 72-yard drive, and they come away with 7 points.
You know, this offensive line has done a really good job, but really, I think it's more about the big play ability from the running backs and why we've seen so many big plays from this offense.
He's to the 20. He makes it out to maybe the 20-yard line. So now both teams running back out onto the field. Taken down at the 29-yard line. Quick release, tight end, incomplete.
Harris was the intended receiver on the play. Third down.
It's third down, and this offense is about 3 feet away from that first down marker. Just under two to go in the game. He fires. Got it to the senior. They'll bring him down at the 29.
The offense caught him flat-footed to convert that third and long. You can tell by the coach's reaction that that is a huge disappointment.
Let's go! Blue 45! Blue 45!
Makes the grab and steps out right away.
That makes it first and 10.
First and 10. Ball on the 12. They'll line up with five wide receivers. Quick strike to the receiver. Ball is loose. So a momentum shift could be in the making here as we take a look at the possible fumble. And the booth is going to take a few looks at this to see whether or not the ball came out before he was down.
After reviewing the play, the ruling on the field is reversed.
So after some discussion, the call on the field is reversed. They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. Five guys will be out in the pattern as they're in the shotgun. And he's tackled just outside the
goal.
They'll spread the field with five wide. Zips it to his receiver. Touchdown.
Yeah.
passing game, it was absolutely the right call in that situation.
And he converts the extra point. Bring him down at the 42-yard line. And we see this offense again after what you, Kirk, called a very physical touchdown drive.
Well, I say that, Brad, because the big hog mollies up front were able to create holes for the running game, and it helped them get the score. Let's see if they can do it again.
He's taken around the 32-yard line. Ole Miss will have one timeout remaining. It's second down, and they're about the length of the football from the first down marker.
Under a minute left in the game.
He makes it to the 32-yard line. So he decides to hold on to it, and that's going nowhere. Ole Miss has called their final timeout. He makes it out to maybe the 29-yard line. It's first and 10, ball on the 29. And this should be a kneel down as they just try to kill the clock. He takes a knee, looking to take some time off that clock. Offense and more offense in this one, and it's finally over. 31-21 Bulldog. That's going to do it for this presentation of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, this is Brad Nessler saying goodbye.